I mean, some hard sparring in there today. hard work, this boxing game, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's hard work. How are you doing, mate? Anyway, what are you up to? What have you got coming up since I last spoke to you?
Yeah, so I'm good. Back training in the gym a while now with Mark and Dave, and I'm fighting on Steve Wood's card on the 8th April at Blackpool Winter Gardens. So I think about 7 or 8 fights on the card. And Ricky Adams doing a bit for prostate cancer, like a charity speak after. So that's my first fight back out.
Yeah, brilliant, brilliant. Yeah, it'd be good to see you back in there, mate. Big fight this weekend. We're just talking about it then off camera. Calm, Brooke, how are you seeing this fight? I mean, it's a great fight. I was speaking to Matty there, saying it's probably, I know everyone's saying it's a bit late, but it's actually, the fuse has been lit and it's a massive fight. Everyone's looking forward to it. So maybe in that, it might not be technically a better one, but in terms of the stature of it, it's quite a big fight.
Yeah, it's late in the day for them both, but it's still intriguing. I bet there's not much going on social media without actually everybody talking about it, whether you're a boxing fan, whether you're a casual fan, whether you're a boxing person, everyone's talking about it, and it is intriguing. As far as who's going to win, if it was 3-4 years ago, I might have gone Kell Brook. Amir Khan's speed's good, Kell Brook's last few performances haven't been the best, so I'm going to go Khan, I think.
How do you see the fight playing out?
If Kell Brook's going to win, it's going to be early doors. He's going to catch him here when he's coming in the run of his flurries if he switches off for a minute, but I think if Khan can keep it a distance in and out of range and buzz him constantly, hitting threes and fours, nothing but threes and fours, I think Khan wins it late on all points.
Yeah, late on all points. I think there'll be a few twists and turns along the way, and Brooks the favourite as well going in. Do you think we've got it right there?
I mean, on paper you might say, yeah, he's had a few losses, he's had, I don't know how many fights he's had in Paris, he's had probably a similar amount of fights together. Yeah, he could have it right, but for me, Amir Khan just proved himself when he's in with a better opponent. I mean, even when he boxed someone like Canelo, don't get me wrong, he was never going to beat Canelo, that was inevitable, that outcome, but he was nicking rounds off him, he was faster, he was in and out, and that's against like an elite level like Canelo. I think he's going to be too fast, too quick. I think if Kell Brook's going to do that, I think he'll have to, similar to what Canelo did, he'll by his time and catch him with a big left hook or an uppercut or something like that. But I think if Amir Khan can get it to them late round and keep going, I think he can do it on points or a late stoppage with them flurries or punches he throws.
Are you going to the fight?
I'm not, I'm just going to watch it all.
Right. I was thinking about you the other night when John Ryder beat Daniel Jacobs, and yeah. you beat John Ryder a few years ago. Makes your win look even better every time, but we said they deserves a bit of luck, John, and he got it there, so it was a good win for him, wasn't it? And like I say, you had a bit of history with him.
Yeah, fantastic win for him. He has had a bit of bad luck. Our fight was relatively close. The Rocky Fielding fight was arguably either way. Callum Smith fight, the same again for a world title. There's arguments to say he won. In my eyes, I give him as winning the fight, but I might have been a bit more prejudiced towards him because I boxed him and wanted him to win, but you know, yeah, he deserved that win. Like I said, if it had gone to Danny Jacobs, you couldn't moan. It was a great fight. Danny Jacobs probably won 5 out of the first 6 or 4 out of the first 6, so John Mayer quite strong in the second half. Yeah, I'm buzzing for him, really happy he got that win.
Brilliant. Well, mate, it's good to catch up with you. And good luck in your next fight. Just remind us again the date, and I'll put it on the screen.
It's on the 8th of April at Blackpool Winter Gardens.
Blackpool Winter Gardens. Brilliant, mate. Great to catch up with you, and I'll speak to you soon.